Hello everyone, we present an empirical study of training self-supervised vision transformers. This work is jointly done by Xinlei, Sanning, and Kaibin from FAIR.
Self-supervised learning is a promising learning paradigm and is of central importance across many different domains in AI because of its ability to avoid the cost of annotating large-scale datasets. There are two key elements in today's state-of-the-art systems for self-supervised learning. The first one is about the pre-training method. In NLP, masked or autoregressive modeling tasks, such as BERT or GPT, have proven to be very successful. On the other hand, in computer vision, contrastive or Siamese learning-based approaches also led to great advances in representation quality and transfer performance. The second element is the backbone architecture to be used in self-supervised learning. In computer vision, convolutional neural networks, for example, residual networks, have been the go-to choice, while transformer-based models dominate the field of natural language processing. Recently, there has been an exciting trend of unifying backbone architectures across domains, as the transformer-based architectures can also show promising results in image recognition tasks. Given this progress, our work situates itself within a context of studying transformer architectures and contrastive learning objectives for image-based self-supervised learning. To recap, the transformer architecture was first introduced in the seminal paper Attention is All You Need from Google in 2017. This architecture that replaced the traditional recurrent networks with a multi-head attention mechanism has become the dominant architecture in NLP. The original text transformer takes as input a sequence of words which it then uses for classification, translation, or other NLP tasks. Last year, a new architecture was introduced called the Vision Transformer, or VIT, which makes very few modifications to the transformer design to make it operate directly on images instead of words. VIT divides an image into graded patches. Each patch is flattened into a single vector, then linearly projected to the desired input dimension. VIT has less inductive bias compared to confidence, as it does not know that the image has 2D structure. Learnable position embeddings are added to each patch, allowing the model to learn about the structure of the images. With this simple design, VIT not only shows great results compared to the modern vision architectures, but also shows extremely promising signals in terms of the scaling behavior with respect to the model size and dataset size, yielding great performance compute trade-off, especially at larger computer scales.
We pick MoCo, or momentum contrast, as our learning method, as it is a standard baseline framework for SSL in vision. The key concepts in MoCo are contrastive learning and momentum encoder. In contrastive learning, an augmented view of an image x0 is fed into an encoder for embedding p0. Another view of the same image is fed into the same encoder, and the output P0 prime forms a positive pair with P0. A view from a different image produces P1, and it forms a negative pair with P0. Contrastive learning objective is to attract positive pairs while dispel negative pairs. Siamese networks are extensively used in such frameworks because the encoders are sharing weights. Instead of the original encoder, MoCo uses a momentum encoder to form positive and negative pairs. The momentum encoder weights are exponential moving averages of the original encoder weights. It usually leads to better performance and training stability, and is widely used nowadays. MoCo has been evolving. In V1, MoCo pre-training surpassed supervised counterparts on multiple vision tasks. MoCo V2 mainly improves on the ImageNet linear probing performance. And in this work, we use V3, which strikes a better balance among simplicity, accuracy, and scalability. Here is the pseudocode for MoCo V3. For all details, please refer to the released code. Different from V1 and V2, we use a symmetric loss, get negative pairs directly from the same batch, and borrowed predictor and augmentation recipes from Bayer. Overall, MoCoV3 obtains the state-of-the-art ImageNet linear probe performance with a ResNet 50 backbone, at par with Bayer. Next, we explore MoCoV3 plus VIT. We use the VIT-based encoder and a pre-trained encoder with Adam Optimizer 4K batch size for 100 epochs. During pre-training, we installed an online k-nearest neighbor monitor to closely track the training progress per iteration. The monitor uses frozen output features from the class token and reports ImageNet 1K classification accuracy on the training set. With the monitor, we spot an instability issue, especially when training VITs with large batch size or large learning rate. Specifically, it will have dips where the curve suddenly drops and then restarts with a new trajectory. This is different from the divergence behavior we typically see when learning rate is too big. With dips, it reaches a lower KNN accuracy in the end, which is also reflected in the linear probe evaluation. This is an important issue, not only because it degrades performance, but also because it hinders research explorations. It is also general, as it is echoed by one of the original VIT authors on social media, that the exact same behavior was observed on their end. We present a simple trick to improve training stability, random patch projection. The idea is to apply a stop gradient operation right after the patch projection layer in VIT throughout the training process, so it remains random. It narrows down the solution space for the optimizer and works pretty well across different learning rates as shown on the right side. We also find it useful for other SSL frameworks for VIT, but we note it is not a fundamental solution to the issue. For example, it can be sensitive to the initialization methods for patch projection layers.
We benchmarked self-supervised VIT in four different frameworks: MoCoV3, SameClear, Bayer, and Swerve. We use the same random projection trick in all cases. MoCoV3, which is contrastive-based and uses momentum encoder, has better accuracy on VIT than other frameworks. We also find that different frameworks behave differently. From the figure, we can see that MoCoV3 and SimClear are more favorable for the transformer backbone than the ResNet backbone. We are able to obtain the state-of-the-art results of 81% top-1 accuracy in ImageNet linear evaluation protocol by adopting two additional strategies. The first one is to use batch normalization instead of the default layer normalization used in VIT backbone's MLP blocks. We also explore training with longer sequences in VIT by reducing the patch size to 7x7. This keeps the model size unchanged, but increases flops to around 6x larger. Beyond the linear evaluation protocol, we also report end-to-end fine-tuning results. MoCoV3 achieves 83.2% with VIT base, substantially better than the training from scratch results. With a bigger model of VIT large, MoCoV3 achieves 84.1. As a final set of experiments, we evaluate transfer learning to four other downstream datasets. Our self-supervised VIT has better transfer learning accuracy when the model size increases from VIT base to VIT large. As a comparison, the ImageNet supervised VIT becomes saturated or overfitted starting at VIT large. The overfitting is more prominent when training the big VIT models from scratch in these small datasets. The accuracy in general decreases with bigger VIT. We also find that from scratch VIT results are much worse than their ResNet counterparts in these small datasets. This suggests that if data are not enough, it is difficult to train VIT that has no inductive biases. Self-supervised pre-training is promising as it can close this gap and largely reduce overfitting in small datasets. Thank you very much. All the pre-trained models, as well as the code that can reproduce all the ImageNet linear evaluation, ImageNet end-to-end fine-tuning, and downstream transfer learning experiments are all available online. Please let us know if you have any questions. Thank you.